Hello, friends. Welcome back. We're doing the 1.8 survival. It has been a bit of a while, so I've actually forgotten which direction we're exploring. Might be... If I were clever, I would have cooked up my raw beef while I was off camera. And I might do that. I have no armor. No, I do have armor. Wow, I was more advanced than I thought I was. A bunny? The bunny down there? Whoosh. It is a bunny. So, we're still exploring. Trying to find a good home base. I know, typically one finds a good home base earlier than this, but this is how I do. I like to explore. It's one of the things I like about the game of Minecraft. One of the things I like about updates is that there are new things to explore. So I'm thinking, as I've done, as of this one, 3 or 4 survival videos and 3 or 4 Cube Realm videos, it might be a good idea, how's my coal, to start splitting it instead of having the A New Start video series combine everything. Don't know. Maybe not yet. We'll see if I get any people who watch and care. If not, I'll just keep doing this because it's fun. And for whatever reason, I have more fun when I've got the microphone on. Ooh, that's a neat place. Let's get a little closer. Hi, cows. So many cows. You'll note I do not have smooth graphics on. This is still using the Cube Realm texture pack. 1.8 does clever things where it doesn't spend any time rendering things that are out of view. So sometimes if you look quickly, you'll see something not quite properly put together. Alright, ooh, that's pretty. Is that where I came from? Alright, we're getting into sunset. I want to lay down my bed before the monsters start spawning. It's still early, but we'll try. Oh, it's not too early. Right, I was going to look into this crevasse. It's kind of neat looking space. Wonder if this counts as a river. It is. Oh, I can have it extreme hills. Always takes me a ridiculous amount of time to find what I'm looking for on the F3 screen. I like the new stone blocks. I wish they had more practical use. But not everything in Minecraft has to be about being practical. I don't know. I don't feel like settling into extreme hills, so I think I'll actually circumnavigate them. Because they're kind of a hassle to pass through, if they're not my actual target. I see no real reason to cut through, except to see pretty things. I'm hoping to find a place in this video so I can get a good screenshot of it and maybe use it as the thumbnail for this series. I can... My thought is perhaps use the survival thumbnail for the survival videos and the Cube Realm thumbnail for the Cube Realm videos. And I have another series I'd like to do. I've got a heavily modded Forge profile, which mostly adds creepy things. You know, more mobs, more biomes, the gravestone, Twilight Forest. I mean, not all of that is creepy, of course, but some creepy stuff shows up. I've played it a few times. I have to admit, every time an ogre comes on screen, I switch to peaceful to make it go away. I don't know if they're easy or hard to kill. I imagine they're hard to kill, but they keep messing up the terrain. Oh, and roguelike. Roguelike dungeons is the other mod. Why does the sky go dark when we're in the river? Might find a village. Villages are good places to sort of set up a temporary base. A problem with a village is that essentially the player visiting the village brings death. The villagers go in at night, but they tend to come out before the zombies burn up. And before the player arrives, the village is unloaded. So everything is fine, nothing has really interacted. You show up, it's loaded, it's running, and within a couple nights there are no villagers left. So if I do visit a village, I'll try within the first day to protect it. Although I know some people just put blocks in front of the doors to keep them in, and that would work. Certainly easier than putting up fences and lights all over. It's a lot of prairie. Prairie, is that what these are called? Plains. A lot of plains. So yeah, I think I will... Ooh. Spider cow. I think I will promise to start base this session. As I walk around with a bed in my hand. I will find a place to settle this session. I'm not sure whether I'm gonna get any further than Dirt Hut. At least get a start. Oop. That's foolish. There's no chance of me getting... Look, I have a shovel. Use it. Trees in the way. Really? Come on. Sound always reminds me a bit of a train. Hi, bunny. Unless I get to brewing, I'm more or less going to leave the bunnies alone. Because they don't produce much. I mean, they've got decent food, I guess. But they're so cute. And for food and a quarter of a piece of leather... Get a bit better deal just going after the cows, which seem very plentiful in this map. Alright. Going through the forest. Sheep. Chickens. Seems like good farming territory. What am I even looking for? Forests are good. I like the look of them. Oh, this is 1.8. I can up the video settings. Let's see. What if I do smooth lighting? Drop it back to 12. Let's see how that goes. So much faster. Love it. Okay, so now I can see a bit further. When I get a high vantage, I might be able to see more of the terrain. I'm not sure why I started doing this now. It's actually an awkward time because I'm moving soon. And no matter how well that goes, I'm probably gonna. Oh, there's a village! Probably gonna have to take a break in it during the move, but I've got some preloaded. I've actually got videos running through till mid-October at the moment. I think we'll cut into November with this one on a weekly. All right. You know what? I think I will settle near the village. I'm gonna make this my screenshot. Got the covered forest there. We've got a regular forest there. We've got plains. We've got lots of forest. Won't be suffering for wood. Let's see what we got. We've got good-sized gardens. Hi, buddy. Woo. Let me help these guys out a little. We spend a little time opening doors and unblocking doors. Where's the entrance to this one? It's got to be buried. There's someone in there? What is with the cobblestone? Oh wait, cobble under gravel is a new thing. So that the roads in villages aren't quite as terrible. Right, I'm gonna take a real quick break. I'll be back before you know it. F9, please. All right, I'm back. The video is about 12 minutes long. Which is kind of amazing because I haven't done anything yet. All right, well, no blacksmith, which is a shame. Think come sunset, I'll block everyone in. Because my presence, as I've said, is dangerous to villagers. We on sunset? Sunset, sunsetting. Go inside. Go inside. Go inside. You, go inside. No, don't come to the garden. Don't do gardening. There. He went inside. He's smart. You go inside too. Go inside. Go inside. Go inside. Go inside. Gonna get killed. Well, I guess they do generally go inside. Eventually. I'll just block them in before dawn. No trampling the crops, you. Moon's up. Why aren't everyone inside? Come on. Run. Hurry. There you go. What about you, buddy? You should be inside. Go. Go on, go inside. Oh, pathing. Holy pathing trouble, Batman. Go on inside. Go on. Shut the damn door. You guys. Alright. Block you in. As long as we at least have a breeding pair, we'll do okay. Let's see. Into a house. Come on. Is there anyone in there? There is. He wants to go to that one. Alright, fine. I'll help you with a pet.
Where'd he go?
Come on, into a house. Hurry up. Come on. Come on. Come on. Into the house. Thank you. Anyone in there? No. Where are you going? Why is there a patch of sand there? Go into a house! Come on! Quick! Before the zombie hordes come. There's one already. Alright, lock you in. Okay, did we actually get anyone in there? No. I don't like that one. Anyone still outside? Yeah, there we go. Come on, babies, I'm trying to protect you. For your own good. Why are you still outside? Go in. I spleef you. I see you. Try and keep from losing any tonight. Skeletons and creepers. Let's hope this isn't a social zombie night. I'm not sure I can manage a whole horde. Though I kind of know where they're going to be trying to get. Should make some doors for the doorless ones so they'll breed. Hi! One of you nice guys want to drop me a bow when I kill you? There's always creepers. Okay, at this point, I'm going to go into a house, lay down my bed, see if it will let me sleep. Of course, this is dangerous because the zombies are right outside, often, and the villagers try to come out. But I think they're all inside, successfully. Except that guy. What's wrong with you? Alright, so let's see, where will I set up my home? Oh, hi. I wish these roads went places. That would be cool. I'm gonna just set up in this little valley. It's not particularly impressive terrain. I honestly don't remember picking up the pumpkin. All right. So let's set up what we've got. We've got furnaces. We've got a crafting bench. We'll make a chest. Oh, we have a chest. Start cooking our meat. Wood? Wood. Let's make it out of. I'm going to start with a floor of dark oak and birch in a checkerboard. I don't usually start with the floor, but I think that's what I'm going to do this time. I'm going to spiral up one of these bad boys. Do this with jungle trees too. Just sort of fake a spiral staircase inside the tree. Get the side branches on the way. Careful though, you can hurt yourself. What I often do is break the block I'm standing on and fall, take fall damage. Not too bad, because you fall down to a lower step rather than to the ground. Waiting for a skeleton to shoot me in the back. Notice that the break pattern on the tall grass looks like a rose bush. Just for a split second there. Pretty sure that's not supposed to happen. Alright, we'll get us a birch tree. Lots of good free-range chicken and sheeps. I'm going to mob-proof the village before I start letting them out. I should have checked what their, there's a swamp nearby. That could be interesting. Check out what some of their trades are. I'll be doing that as well. I don't like abusing the NPCs. Oh, nice river. Maybe I should set up on the river. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So just a little farther back from where I set up my workspace. Still in the same direction at the end of the road, if the road had continued. Yeah. Overlooking the river. So, I want to say here in this clearing. I have a bucket. The best way. Do I have enough things for. I do. The best way to clear grass and flowers from a large area is with a bucket of water. So we'll do that. Probably make some shears since there are sheep all over the place. This way, this way, this way. Up the hill. It'll be nice and picturesque. I'll make sort of a fairly calm, quaint place, and then I'll maybe make some big tower up on top of the hillside. Just give us a little ground to work on. As I said, we're going to start with birch planks and dark oak. Don't ask me why, it was just what came to mind. And make a mistake doing this. Just somehow get confused partway along the way. Okay, well, if I cut that one, then I've got my square. And find a good picture here and take a screenshot of that instead. Because I think we're set for our 20-minute goal. Any way I can get a hint of the village? I can. Let's try this. It's kind of an odd one, but it actually shows the beginning of the build. Alright, friends, we will call that a day for this session. Thanks for coming along.